Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2036, Intro to Solver. All right, I'm podcasting this entire book. Click the I on the top right-hand corner to get to the playlist where you can play all the videos. Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. We talked about some what-if analysis recently, like goal seek, you know, with one input cell that you're changing. But what if you have something more complex? Well, there's a great tool called Solver. Solver's been around for a long time. I guarantee if you have Excel and you're running on Windows, you have Solver. It's just probably not turned on. So to turn it on, you have to go to Alt-T, and then I. So T for Tom, I for ice cream, and check this box for Solver. Click OK, and after a couple of seconds, you'll have a Solver tab out here on the right-hand side. All right, and we're going to set up a model here that Solver might be able to solve. We have an amusement park. We're trying to figure out how many employees to schedule. Everyone works 5 days, five consecutive days. So there's really seven possible schedules where you're off Sunday, Monday, off Monday, Tuesday, Tuesday, Wednesday. We have to figure out how many employees to put on each of those schedules. And so just simple little math here, doing some SUMPRODUCTs of, you know, number of employees times Sunday to figure out how many people are there on Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. And what we've learned through operating this amusement park is we need a lot of people on Saturday and Sunday, 30 people on Saturday and Sunday. During the week, Monday, Tuesday, kind of slow, 12 staff will be able to do it. All right, so just by coming along here and just screwing around, you know, trying to figure out the right numbers, you can just keep plugging things in. But with seven different choices, it would take forever. All right, so now in Solver, what we have is we have a series of input cells. And in the free version of Solver, I think you can have, is it 100? I don't know, there's some number. And if you have to go beyond that, there's a premium Solver that you can get from Frontline Systems. All right, so we have some input cells. We have some constraint cells. And then you have to bring it all down to a final number. So in my case, I'm trying to minimize payroll per week. So that green number is what I want to try and optimize. All right, so here's what we're going to do. Solver. Here's the objective cell. It's the green cell. And I want to set that to a minimum value. Figure out the staffing that gets me the minimum value by changing these blue cells. And then here are the constraints. All right, so the first constraint is that the schedule total has to be greater than or equal to the red section. And we can do all that as a single constraint. Watch how cool this is. All of these cells have to be greater than or equal to these corresponding cells here. Awesome. Click Add. All right. But then there's other things that you wouldn't think of. For example, Solver at this point might decide that it's best to have 17 people on this schedule, 4.3 people on this schedule, and -7 people on this schedule. All right, so we have to tell Solver that these input cells have to be an integer. Click Add. And also, we can't have someone not show up and they'll give us their salary back, right? So we're going to say these cells have to be greater than or equal to 0. Click Add. Go back. Now we have our three constraints there. There's three different types of ways to solve, and this one it follows linear, it's a linear math, so we can just go with simplex LB. If this one doesn't work, then by all means try the other two. I've had cases where the simplex says it can't find a solution and one of the other two work. Frontline Systems has great tutorials on Solver. I'm just trying to get you through your first one here today. I don't proclaim to be a Solver expert. Once I had a Solver that wouldn't work, and I sent a note into Frontline Systems, and wow, I got this awesome 5-page letter back, right, from Dan Filester himself, the president of Solver. And it started out, "Dear Bill, great to hear from you," and then went on for 4.9 pages that was all pretty much completely above my head. All right, but you know, I know enough about Solver to get through this. All right, so we're going to click here on Solve. It found a solution. All constraints and optimality conditions are satisfied. I'm going to keep that. I can create some reports don't need to do that right now. Oh, I can actually save a scenario. I made fun of scenarios yesterday. Maybe Solver would be able to create a new scenario for me. So we'll click OK. All right, and sure enough, it saved us money. We were at 2584 before, and now it got us down to 2040. So we need a lot of people off on Monday and Tuesday. All right, some people, two people off on Wednesday, Thursday, and then Friday, Saturday. Well, this is awesome. I never would have just randomly come up with this set of answers. All right, but does that mean it's the best answer? Well, it means that it's the minimum payroll, but I can probably come up with a different set of answers that would still have this minimum payroll. There's other ways to do that that might be a slightly better schedule. Like, for example, right now we have 28 people on Wednesday and Thursday when we only need 15 and 18. That's a lot of people. Think about who works at amusement parks. You know, these are college kids on home for break. This is going to be trouble if we have that many extra people. And on Monday, Tuesday, we're dead even exactly where we want to be. So that means if any one of them call off sick, now we're going to have to, you know, call someone in and pay them time and a half because they've already worked five other days. All right. So just with some simple little math here, if I would take 8 away from Monday, Tuesday and make it 10 and take those 8 and add them to Wednesday, Thursday, all right, now I have a solver solution with the exact same answer, 2040. They got the right number of people. I just balanced out the schedule, and now we have 8 extra, 8 extra, 3 extra, and 2 extra, and exactly what we need on the weekend, which are, you know, the full staff scenario. To me, this is slightly better than what Solver came up with. Does that mean that Solver failed? No, absolutely not, because I never would have gotten this close without Solver. Once Solver gave me the answer, yeah, I was able to tweak it a little bit and get there. All right, tip number 37, 40 greatest Excel tips of all time, getting near the end of that first 40. Great little introduction to Solver. The guide to all of the podcasts in this series is here, Mr. Excel, Excel, the 40 greatest Excel tips of all time. You can have the ebook for just $10, print book for $25. Click the I in the top right hand corner. All right, recap, Solver. If you're in Windows versions of Excel, Lotus 1-2-3, it's there. It's created by VisiCorp founder Dan Feilstra. It's a free version of the heavy duty solvers. Here's a link to go check out the heavy duty solvers. That'll be down in the YouTube comments. It's probably there, just not installed. Alt-T-I, checkmark solver. Look on the right side of the data tab to find solver. All right, you have to have an objective cell that you're trying to minimize or maximize or set to a value. One range of input cells. Specify constraints, including something you wouldn't expect, like I had to say no half people and no negative people. Solver will find the optimal solution, but there might be others that are ties, and you might be able to tweak it to get a better solution. All right, there you have it. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.